John's reagent. This is a very specific oxidizing agent used to oxidize alcohols. Why I am saying specific oxidizing agent? In general, we use potassium permanganate and potassium dichromate, K2Cr2O7, to oxidize the alcoholic group. But these are strong oxidizing agent and oxidizes alcohol to carboxylic acid. But before converting alcohol to carboxylic acid, alcohol is converted to aldehyde at first. The carbon number of carbon remain constant, then this aldehyde is converted to carboxylic acid. So these are the specific oxidizing agent. So why these are the specific oxidizing agent? Let's see. At first, what is John's reagent? Chromic acid. Chromic acid in aqueous acetone. Chromic acid, the structure or the formula is H2CrO4 in presence of acetone. In presence of acetone, this is what we call John's reagent. So this is a specific oxidizing agent, and the most convenient reagent for the oxidation of alcohol in 8 normal chromic acid. It is not required to remember the normality. In presence of sulfuric acid is known as John's reagent, and this is the actual balanced reaction which I have mentioned. So if you take primary alcohol with chromic acid, this primary alcohol is converted to ketone. Sorry, this is a secondary alcohol and it is converted to ketone. If you take primary alcohol, it is converted to aldehyde. And chromic acid H2CrO4 is converted to CrCO3. See, 1 degree alcohol and 2 degree alcohol are converted to, 1 degree alcohol is converted to aldehyde by John's reagent, 2 degree alcohol is converted to ketone by John's reagent, and with 3 degree alcohol, generally it is unable to oxidize by John's reagent. If you take 3 degree alcohol with John's reagent, it will give you chromate ester because of the absence of this hydrogen. So what is the mechanism of John's reagent? Let's consider the mechanism. So I have taken example of secondary alcohol which is treated with this chromic acid. Chromic acid, the structure is Cr, double bond O, O, single bond H, O, single bond H. The oxidation state of chromium is +6. So at first, the lone pair of this oxygen approaches to this chromium, and because of this, both the electron of these oxygen are accepted by oxygen atom. So oxygen get negative charge, chromium get neutralized because it accept pair of electron, and the oxygen from this alcohol now converted to positive, and this hydrogen is replaced. After replacing this hydrogen, this oxygen become neutral. Now this is the actual structure. So again, one OH group will attack to this chromium, and the alpha position hydrogen is eliminated, forming aldehyde. So because this structure is a little bit small, I am elaborating this structure. See, if you take secondary alcohol, you will get one hydrogen at this position, and this is the oxygen, this is chromium, double bond O, OH, and this will become O minus, and there is one more OH group. So I have increased the structure of this one. So what happened in this mechanism? These are the two electrons. These two electrons are come to this position, forming a double bond between carbon and oxygen, and both the electrons are taken by chromium. So if this bond cleavage take place, it will give you ketone, R double bond O, and this will be removed. Now consider, you have taken initially tertiary alcohol. This is the example of secondary. If you take tertiary alcohol, in place of this hydrogen, you will have one R group. So it is not possible to remove R as R plus, as I am going to remove this H as H plus. So this will be the final product if you take 3 degree alcohol, which is also known as chromate ester. Let's take few example of John's reagent, which is generally asked in exam. If you take secondary alcohol, it is converted to ketone. If you take primary alcohol, it is converted to aldehyde. But in general, acetonic medium of John's reagent convert this aldehyde to carboxylic acid, further oxidized. But ketone are not further oxidized. So can I say, if I take small concentration of 1 degree alcohol, very mild, if in exam it is mentioned that mild concentration of John's reagent, you can able to form aldehyde, but these are not the good method to prepare aldehyde because aldehyde are further oxidized to carboxylic acid. If there is no condition mentioned, just they have written John's reagent and they have given primary alcohol, just convert primary alcohol to carboxylic acid. Now, this is again a primary alcohol at low temperature, alpha position. There is a unsaturated double bond, it is converted to aldehyde. Again, the concentration, if the concentration is very high, it is converted to further oxidized to carboxylic.